I want people to feel something, whether it's, you know, joy or grieving or their process of healing, all of it.
I wanted to make songs that made me want to dance, but also said the things that I still wanted to say in my singer-songwriter music.
We want longevity, you know, I think that's the aim of the band, is to just keep going, keep moving, keep working.
Until we're old.
Until we're old.
When I was 13, I told my mom I was ready to be famous, and she laughed at me. I wanted to see if I could make it as a performer, but I didn't really believe that it was gonna happen for me.
We started 7 years ago, getting booed off stage in bars and clubs and people throwing stuff.
I kind of got knocked on my ass a little bit because everyone wants to do what you're doing and what makes you special. And it was kind of like, what do I have to do to stand out?
Right now, we're at a crossroads with mainstream music and things that are on the radio, where we're missing a lot of messages. And I want to create a pop music that has depth on top of the emotion.
You do feel the pressure.
You want it to be successful, and you've worked so hard at it, and you hope people relate to it and they love it.
The famous quote is, Betty Who just might save pop music. I don't know if pop music really needs saving, but it's cool to be thought of as somebody who is making a difference.
I'm singing to 10,000 people, and they're singing these words back to me. It was at that moment where I was like, I can do this. I can have all of these messages that I care very deeply about, and it's gonna resonate with people.
I think now that a lot of it's down to just people coming to see us live, and I think they just get it, and they get that we're totally about the music.
As I'm singing you a song, I'm telling you a story about me and about you, and maybe we can connect on that. You and I can have a moment where we emote together about the same thing, but two different experiences. Human connection is like what everybody looks for.